So today we will be talking about osteoporosis and osteoporosis related fractures in the spine. As you know that bone quality is a big issue, and we see younger and younger population having a problem related to the osteoporosis. When we look at the bone, generally this is the vertebra, and when you look at the bone, can you see the difference, this particular bone, and when we look at the bone which is this, there is a big difference between the two. And I tell you what is the difference. If you look at these two models, you can see here, you can see the upper end plate and the lower end plate, and you can see the thick bone which is interconnecting between these two components. And when you look at this particular bone, you can see very thin bone, you can see very thin layer on the upper end, you can see the thin bone, and you can see that the interconnections, they are actually disconnected, they are broken, they are thinner, and there is a lesser and lesser number of a trabeculae. We call them trabeculae. There is a lesser and lesser number of a trabeculae. Now what happens, that because of the poor quality of the bone, as the menopausal, postmenopausal osteoporosis sets in, what we see is that there is a more and more bone loss which starts to happen from the skeleton of an individual. There is something called a peak bone mass which we achieve at the age of 30 and 40. And after that, there is, as soon as the postmenopausal or perimenopausal stage starts to set in a lady, and andropause in a man above the age of 65, and in the females around 45 and 50, there is an accelerated loss of a bone which starts in the body. There is a cycle of bone formation and bone loss which continues. So what we generally see that in about 7 years of a period, we actually replace whole of the skeleton of ours by this cycle of bone resorption and bone formation. Now, because of the poor quality of the bone, it reaches a level where actually bone has become very, very thin and fragile. And what we call it as a fragility fracture, or what we call a vertebral compression fractures, and they occur very easily. There can be trivial fall from the standing height of a person if it falls and breaks his wrist or breaks his hip or breaks his spine. And we have seen that, you know, over a pothole or a speed breaker, if the car jumps over, there can be just compression of the vertebral fractures. And these so-called vertebral fractures mostly are seen in mid zone. This is the middle of the spine, what we call a thoracolumbar area. And generally, either one or two of these vertebrae, they get compressed, and that is why. So in a fracture, in other places, we see that the bones break away and there is a separation of the two fragments. However, in the spine, the fracture is slightly different. Here, it actually gets further compressed. So there is a change in the height of these various bones, 33 vertebrae which we have. So there is a change in the height. You can see that there may be wedging, there can be overall height decrease in the vertebrae, there can be deformity formation. And we have seen that these patients actually present with lot of pain. There is a spasm, there is a movement restriction, and they are constantly in lot of discomfort. And generally, these days, if there is a lot of discomfort and patient wants to be ambulatory very early and very quickly, what we do is, these days, we do a cemented filling of these broken vertebrae or a compressed vertebrae. What is done in that is, these are the percutaneous procedures with the help of a needle. Just from the posterior aspect, two needles are passed in an affected vertebra. And what we do is, we use a liquid cement which is actually passed through the channels into that broken bone, and the portion which was compressed is refilled with the help of a cement. And cement gives two advantages. One, it actually fills in the cavity, so it gives a shape to the vertebra. And second major advantage, it immediately causes pain-free state. So ambulation, activity, movement, and you know, when patient needs to move to the washroom, move to the dining table. And in fact, we have had patients who had visits planned to foreign countries or to their relatives, or a leisure visit plans to different places. If they land up with such an injury, we have even allowed them to move out for these visits very quickly, within a week or so. So this has got a major advantage. So this helps only to fill in the symptom, fill in the cavity with the help of a bone cement, which takes care of the pain and discomfort. However, please do not forget to treat the osteoporosis, which definitely needs a separate treatment. And these days there are two groups of medications, and especially if there is a fragility fracture, we give anabolic bone builders to these patients, which help build the bone and in the long run improves the quality of the whole of the vertebra and whole of the skeleton for that matter, to prevent risk of refracture, because these patients are high at risk of one fracture. They say fracture begets fracture, and one fracture there is threefold increase, two fracture there is sevenfold increase of refracture, and in a patient who has three fracture there is 11 to 15 fold increase of having these re-vertebral fragility fractures. And medical treatment in the form of improvement of their vitamin D levels, giving them calcium, improving the protein levels in them, because most of these patients have also weakness in their quality of muscles and bone, and bone which gets very less nutrition. So you need to give proteins, collagens, and you also need to give them vitamins, and we also need to give them injections in the form of a daily injection, which is given for a minimum period of approximately 2 years in the form of a subcutaneous injection. It is self-given injection, very easy, and that is how these patients are treated over a period of time, which, and they become ambulatory very early. Within a week they are up and about doing their routine activities. Thank you very much.